Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel PJ Chen Design. Today I'm answering a question from my YouTube subscriber on how to make a split ring. So we are going to do the design on the split ring, and I also like to talk about how to flow the stone on the ring shank. If you are interested in the middle part for halo ring, there's another video talk about how to make them and also the prong set. Please see the link below. Are you ready? Let's get started. So we are going to starting with the ring shank. And again, if you are interested about how to make this part for a halo ring, you can take a look on the video link below. And we will starting about the ring shank. So I'm going to starting at the front view and set it up. My ring shank diameter is 16. And the reason I put it have this in this proportion is I will need to trim it off later on, so I need to actually have it extra thick. The only thing you want to pay attention is about right here, the culet of the stone, right about in the tip of the stone. You don't want to get below the ring shank area, otherwise you will cut it into it. Okay, so I'm going to keep this in this area and I'm gonna lock it so we won't accidentally to move it. All right, so now let's take a look on the right view. In the right view, I'm going to draw a curve, and it's going to be like this, and it's gonna coming up, and it will roughly going something like this. All right, so our goal is to have a shank on the side view look like this. Now, a lot of time, when you are trying to work on the right view, you may snapping into somewhere else. So at the front view, it look really weird. So what we wanted to do is we go to the right view again and we pick up this curve. And let's go ahead to do a project to C plane. So what it does, and we want to delete the input object. So what it does is it give a really flat curve, which is completely flat to the construction plane. All right. So now we have this one. We are going to use the command is leaving under the curve. You have this one curve from the two view. But let's go ahead to record a history first. And then let's go ahead to do the curve from the two view. So we're gonna click this curve as a ring shank and this curve. Very quickly, you're going to get this curve right here. Now, if we look at it and it is way too far away, we may need to edit at this point. So for example, if you turn on the control point, you can actually say, well, I actually like to come out a little bit, and you can see that curve is actually follow with your original curve. Okay, so I'm going to keep it like this and decide where is my ring shank and thickness is going to be. I'm gonna draw a rectangular and snapping to the bottom of that ring shank. For example, I'm gonna have my stone is 1.8 millimeter, so I may wanna have a length for about like 2 millimeter or 2.1, depends if you wanna have a radius. So let's set it for 2.2. And then the second number is how thick you wanted the ring shank to be. I'm going to set it at 2. All right, so this is my profile is going to be, and let's move it back to from the midpoint back to the quadrant. All right, so that's our first one. The second one, I'm simply just gonna copy from the midpoint to the quadrant for the other one. All right, so let's take a look. Now, it felt like it is way too far from the center part. So what we can do is we wanna move it back. You wanna overlapping just a little bit to see, you know, to make sure you can bowling really well. So let's do a test and see if this way will work. We're going to do the test with the surface tool. Under the surface, you have sweep one rail. So let's pick up this curve and this two as a cross section and make sure they all align. I usually like them aligned in the middle of the ring, inside of the ring shank. All right. And we need to make sure we close the sweep. So we will have something like this. And take a look if you like that, and if you don't, and you can adjust it. At my point, this is might be like too tall for it. So I may need to reduce the height of it so it won't look like it is coming up too much. So I'm going to delete this one. And I actually, it wasn't touching the point. That wasn't good. What I mean is this need to be touched on this. No wonder it's too high. Okay. And double make sure it's not going in way too much. It's just, you just need to have it touch it a little bit. All right. So if it look good, I'm going to sweep one more time. Under the surface, you have sweep one rail. This is your rail. This is your cross section. And let's move the arrow inside and facing the same direction. And don't forget to close the sweep. All right. Now you have that one. So we just need to take a look if it look good on both of them on it. So we want to mirror that. Just do a test and see how it looks. All right. So now you have this over there. You can design the bottom of the ring shank sweep again with the other profile if you like to do that, but I will leave it that to you. And also you can design some something like a cluster in the middle area, or like the one I have a big trillion stone in this area to fill it up. Okay, the second part I would like to talk about is how to flow the stone on the top. I'm going to delete one of it, and I'm gonna use this as my reference to do the stone to flow. Okay, so I need to decide where my stone is going to flow. I definitely not going to flow till the bottom of the ring shank, so I wanted it to flow somewhere until there. Okay. I'm gonna mirror this guy to the other side and then going to trim it off the bottom of it. All right, so now I trim it off. I only need the surface on the top. I actually don't need anything else on the bottom. So I'm going to delete anything I don't need it, just won't get confused. All right, so this is the area that we are going to have the stone on top of it. All right, the command we are going to use is create UV curve. We're gonna create a UV curve over here. And as you see, it doesn't look rectangular. It look a little bit like pointed. It's because when we are cutting at the front view and the ring is actually split, it's kind of having a curve. That's why you can see on the right view over here, it is pointy on one side. So that's actually correct. It's actually going to help us to flow it back. We will know the direction. Okay, so the next step is we need to arrange the stone on it. All right, so I cut out a stone is about 1.8 millimeter. And if you want to know how I make this stone, you can go to the link below in the description. I will have a link over there on my other video of how to make a stone. So I'm going to move the stone to the position that I like. It's better to have it right in the middle. So I'm going to use the align tool, and we want to align in the middle. All right, so now this one is aligned. We are going to design the prong. Let's go ahead to draw a prong roughly anywhere about here, and let's go to the right view holding the shift, you want to draw a straight line. We want to do is just simply piping. Okay, so let's go ahead to pipe this guy. And we can have it kind of eyeball it for whatever thickness what we want for this pipe. And it will be something like this. This is really aesthetic decision about how thick you want it to have your prong. However, you don't want your prong to be cut it too much. I usually want to stay as 30% of the prong to maintain the structure and for the better casting. All right, so let's do a test. We are going to move the prong inside of the line that we have, and we want to mirror that prong. Let's go to mirror to the other side and see how they look. All right, and then let's do mirror one more time. This time I want to do is to have that stone to mirror to the other side. All right, so this is will be like how the prong is actually holding. Let me enlarge the top view, kind of see it. This stone is not cutting way too much of it. I will try to keep it 30% as possible, and this one as well. Now, if we move the stone out just a little bit, we can actually move the prong inside of it a little bit. All right, so that gives us a little bit room to the outside edge that your prong won't be filed off too much, and that actually will look better. So this will be a good position. So I'm going to delete one more time and try to mirror one more time to see how they look. You might need to do a couple times to make sure that that is the distance you want. And then we will have this one to mirror to the other side as well by using the midpoint here. All right, so this distance look good to me, and I'm going to have them, and the command I'm gonna use is the array. It's called linear array. I'm going to array how many of it, I'm not so sure. I'm gonna try more than I need. I'm gonna type it 15 here. And first reference point, it's going to be the midpoint. And we try to hold the shift and come back a little bit here. So make sure that it's really close to what we had. And I now have an extra stone I need to do it. All right, so it looks really well. We may need to have this one kind of copy back to the first left side of the first stone. And we did have too much, so I'm going to delete one of them. Okay, it looked like fitting into our space really well. So I'm gonna pick up all my prong and the stone. Let's go ahead to group them. And let's do one more time is to align with them. This time, I'm going to use the center align. So that way, right side and left side will be equal distance. Okay, next what we're going to do is we need to flow it back. So let's go ahead to make that curve into the surface by surface from planar curve. All right, so let's take a look on the perspective view. So you kind of get an idea of where the prong is going to be. And let's flow it back. The command we are going to use is transform. Under the transform, you have flow along the surface. You're going to pick up the prong, and you're gonna pick up the corner, and let's flow it, let me see. Let's flow it back to this corner. And sometimes you will get something like this. I'm gonna keep it this as a tutorial right there. That means our direction is not correct. So you might need to try a few times to get it correct. I was clicking on this corner to that corner. Apparently, I'm clicking on the opposite corner. So I'm gonna try one more time here. Click on this corner and this corner instead. So now it flowed really well, and we just need to double make sure that, you know, they are not flipping or anything like that. Now our stone is on it, we no longer need this surface because that was just for the reference. And I'm going to create another layer and put all the stone and everything into that layer and temporarily just close it. All right, so the reason I'm doing this is because I need to redesign my shank a little bit, because my shank was using the profile of this really square looking profile, and that is going to make the wear is not comfortable. So I'm gonna use that as a reference and use the conic corner and redesign my profile. It's going to have a little bit round profile and something like that. Okay, so that looked good to me, and I'm gonna make a copy from the mid part of the button to the mid part over there. Okay, so that way I will have a rounder, smoother corner. And let's take a look on all full view and look okay to me. So let's use the new profile to do the sweep. Going to the surface, you have sweep one rail, you pick up your rail, and this time we want to pick up the new profile. So let's go ahead to pick up a new profile. Hit enter. Make sure that you bring the seam to inside of the ring shank and facing the same direction. And let's go ahead to close the sweep. All right, as you can see, the corner is nicer. It's not as sharp as that one. And we can bring in back our stone right there. All right, look really nice. And then we can have them to pick up both of them and to mirror to the other side. All right, so that is for the split ring and also how to flow the stone on the top of it. I hope you enjoyed the video. And again, if you're interested in any of the model in the Rhino and you like to know how to make it, please email me or you can leave the comment below, and so I can think about if I can find a way to design a tutorial for you. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next Monday.